Hello students, welcome to my class again. So I hope you may understood the previous classes. So in today's class of the chapter structure of atom, I should discuss about the topics black body radiation. What is black body radiation? Or write short notes on black body radiation. Then photoelectric effect. What do you mean by photoelectric effect? And then Planck's quantum theory. So these topics should be covered in today's class. So at first, what do you mean by black body radiation? Black body radiation. So what is black body radiation? So black body is a system which can absorb all the frequencies of radiations which fall on it. The black body ek system hota hai. So this is a black body. So it is a system. The black body is a system, and this body can absorb all the frequencies of radiation which fall on it. So is body ke upar jo bhi radiation aake girega in any frequency, it can absorb all the frequencies of radiation. So when the black body is heated, when you heat the black body, then it emits all the frequencies of radiations. So we can say that black body is an ideal system which can absorb as well as emits all the frequencies of radiations. So the radiation which is emitted by a black body is called black body radiation. The radiation which is emitted by the black body during heating, that radiation is called black body radiation. Bas ho gaya. What is black body radiation? So black body is a system which can absorb all the frequencies of radiations which fall on it. When the black body is heated, it emits all the frequencies of radiation. Thus, black body is an ideal system which can absorb as well as emit all the frequencies of radiation. So the radiation which is emitted by a black body, is called black body radiation. So our next topic is photoelectric effect. What is photoelectric effect? Photoelectric effect. What is photoelectric effect? So when a beam of light, the beam of light is known as incident light. So when a beam of light with proper frequency falls on a clean surface of alkali metal in vacuum. So alkali metal, so you know, so in the periodic table, group 1 elements except hydrogen. So group 1 elements kya kya hai? So hydrogen hai period 1 mein, hydrogen ke niche period 2 mein hai lithium, then sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, francium. So these are group 1 element in the periodic table. So except hydrogen, hydrogen is not alkali metal. So except hydrogen, these lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, francium, these all elements are called alkali metals. These are alkali metals. So when a beam of light or one incident light falls on a clean surface of alkali metal, तो अगर कोई एल्कली मेटल का सरफेस में एक प्रॉपर फ्रीक्वेंसी से अगर कोई लाइट आके गिरता है देन इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर इजेक्टेड, इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इजेक्ट हो जाता है फ्रॉम द सरफेस ऑफ द मेटल। टू सी इसका डायग्राम से, से दिस इज ए सरफेस ऑफ एल्कली मेटल, एल्कली मेटल सरफेस। सो इन दिस एल्कली मेटल सरफेस से इट इज, दिस इज एल्कली मेटल, एल्कली मेटल सरफेस। सो इन दिस एल्कली मेटल सरफेस से वी कंसीडर दिस इज सोडियम मेटल। तो इन सोडियम हाउ मेनी इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर प्रेजेंट इन वन सोडियम एटम? तो सोडियम इट्स एटॉमिक नंबर 11। तो सोडियम एटम न्यूट्रल होने से इट कंटेन्स 11 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स। So these are the various electrons present in sodium. So these are the 11 electrons present in the sodium metal. A light with proper frequency falls on this clean surface of alkali metal in vacuum. The medium is vacuum. There is no medium. Then what happened? This electron ejected from the surface of the metal. So this is ejected electron. So this is the incident light. Incident light, new frequency, and electron ejected from the surface of the metal. This ejected electron is called, this ejected electron is called photoelectron. This photoelectron. Now see. What is the definition of photoelectric effect? So when a light, when a beam of light with proper frequency falls on the clean surface of alkali metal in vacuum, the electrons are ejected from the surface of the metal. So here I have shown one electron ejected. तो मे बी 2, 3, 4 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इजेक्टेड फ्रॉम द सरफेस ऑफ द मेटल। तो व्हेन ए बीम ऑफ लाइट विद प्रॉपर फ्रीक्वेंसी फॉल्स ऑन द क्लीन सरफेस ऑफ एल्कली मेटल इन वैक्यूम द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर इजेक्टेड फ्रॉम द सरफेस ऑफ द मेटल। दिस फेनोमेनन इज कॉल्ड फोटोइलेक्ट्रिक इफेक्ट। तो व्हेन एक इंसिडेंट लाइट विद प्रॉपर फ्रीक्वेंसी कोई भी एल्कली मेटल सरफेस के ऊपर आता है तो क्या होता है, एल्कली मेटल सरफेस से इलेक्ट्रॉन इजेक्ट होकर बाहर निकल जाता है। तो ये जो फेनोमेनन हुआ दैट फेनोमेनन इज कॉल्ड फोटोइलेक्ट्रिक इफेक्ट। क्लियर? तो द इलेक्ट्रॉन व्हिच इज इजेक्टेड ड्यूरिंग द फोटोइलेक्ट्रिक इफेक्ट इज नोन एज फोटो इलेक्ट्रॉन। तो जो भी इलेक्ट्रॉन इजेक्ट होकर बाहर निकल आएगा ड्यूरिंग फोटो इलेक्ट्रिक इफेक्ट दैट इलेक्ट्रॉन इज कॉल्ड फोटो इलेक्ट्रॉन। एंड यू शुड रिमेम्बर फोटो इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर मोर एनर्जेटिक, इसका एनर्जी ज्यादा होता है, फोटो इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर मोर एनर्जेटिक एज कंपेयर टू द अदर इलेक्ट्रॉन्स प्रेजेंट इन द मेटल सर्फेस। तो देर आर some other electrons also in the metal surface. So the electrons which are ejected during photoelectric effect, that electron is called photoelectron. And photoelectrons are more energetic as compared to the other electrons present in the metal surface. The photoelectrons are ejected only when, ye jo electron kab eject hoga, the photoelectrons are ejected only when the frequency of the incident light, this incident light ka frequency must be contain a certain minimum frequency. The photoelectrons are ejected only when the incident light has a certain minimum frequency, and that minimum frequency is called threshold frequency. Threshold frequency, and threshold frequency symbolizes mu naught. Threshold frequency. इसका मतलब क्या है? Say for example, is electron, just hypothetical example, to eject this electron requires 100 hertz of frequency. तो इस इलेक्ट्रॉन को इजेक्ट करने के लिए 100 hertz फ्रीक्वेंसी चाहिए, ठीक है? So this 100 hertz frequency is called threshold frequency. Now, if the incident light has frequency, this incident light has frequency 80 hertz. अगर incident light का frequency 80 hertz होगा, then can it eject this electron? No, because for ejecting this electron requires 100 hertz of frequency. So that's why the incident light must be contain a minimum certain frequency. So certain minimum frequency is required for the incident light for ejecting the electron. And that certain minimum frequency is called threshold frequency. Now, if the incident light has frequency 120 hertz, so it is more than threshold frequency. When incident light gives 100 hertz of the frequency, then can it eject this electron? Yes, because this frequency, 120 hertz frequency, is more than the threshold frequency. So it can, that frequency can eject one electron from alkali metal surface. So we can say that the photoelectrons are ejected only when the frequency of the incident light have a certain minimum frequency, and that minimum frequency is called threshold frequency. So now, if the frequency of the incident light is more, if the frequency of the incident light is more than the threshold frequency, so if the frequency of the incident light is more than the threshold frequency, then the excess energy is imparted to the photoelectron as its kinetic energy. तो अगर इंसिडेंट लाइट का फ्रीक्वेंसी थ्रेशोल्ड फ्रीक्वेंसी से ज्यादा होता है तो क्या होता है, फोटो इलेक्ट्रॉन का ऊपर जो एक्सेस एनर्जी रहता है वो फोटो इलेक्ट्रॉन्स के ऊपर चला जाता है एज इट्स काइनेटिक एनर्जी. सो सिंस न्यू इज द इंसिडेंट लाइट इंसिडेंट फ्रीक्वेंसी एंड न्यू नॉट इज द थ्रेशोल्ड फ्रीक्वेंसी, तो इफ दिस वैल्यू इज ग्रेटर देन थ्रेशोल्ड फ्रीक्वेंसी, then the excess energy is h nu minus h nu naught. So this much amount of energy is imparted to the photoelectron as its kinetic energy. So we can write the kinetic energy. So kinetic energy, that is half, kinetic energy का formula half m v square. तो kinetic energy of photoelectron is equals to h nu minus h nu naught, that is half m v square equals to h nu minus h nu naught, or h nu इज इक्वल्स टू ये माइनस एच न्यू नॉट किस साइड में आने से प्लस एच न्यू नॉट प्लस हाफ एम वी स्क्वायर और एच न्यू इज इक्वल्स टू डब्ल्यू नॉट प्लस हाफ एम वी स्क्वायर एच न्यू नॉट इज रिटन एज डब्ल्यू नॉट सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द फॉर्मूला काइनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफ फोटो इलेक्ट्रॉन इज इक्वल्स टू एच न्यू माइनस एच न्यू नॉट और एच न्यू इज इक्वल्स टू डब्ल्यू नॉट प्लस हाफ एम वी स्क्वायर तो हियर m m is the mass of electron in kg m is the mass of the electron in kilogram kg v is the velocity of the ejected electron v is velocity of the ejected electron in meter per second nu naught is threshold frequency in second inverse nu is the incident frequency in second inverse h is Planck's constant h represents Planck's constant and w naught is work function w naught is work function we can also represent this expression as h nu this is energy is equals to w naught that is e naught plus half m v square so e equals to e naught plus half m v square we can also write this expression like this so now how can you define or express photoelectric effect in your exam the question may ask like this what is photoelectric effect or what do you mean by photoelectric effect or write short notes on photoelectric effect so the answer is the when a beam of light with proper frequency falls on the clean surface of alkali metal in vacuum electrons are ejected from the surface of the metal this phenomenon is called photoelectric effect the electron which is ejected from the surface of the metal during photoelectric effect is called photoelectron the photoelectrons are ejected only when the incident light has a certain minimum frequency or threshold frequency nu naught so when the frequency of the incident light is more than the threshold frequency then the excess energy that is h nu minus h nu naught is imparted to the photoelectron as its kinetic energy so the kinetic energy of photoelectron that is half mv square is equals to h nu minus h nu naught and this expression can be written as so h nu is equals to h nu naught plus half mv square and h nu naught is written as w naught so h nu equals to w naught plus half mv square where m is the mass of electron in kg v is the velocity of the ejected electron in meter per second nu naught is the threshold frequency in second inverse nu is the incident frequency in second inverse w naught is work function okay so blackbody radiation and photoelectric effect over So our next topic is Planck's quantum theory. Planck's quantum theory. So here, Planck's quantum theory was established in 1900 just to explain the phenomenon of black body radiation and photoelectric effect. So in order to explain the phenomenon of black body radiation and photoelectric effect, Max Planck in 1900 put forwarded a theory known as Planck's quantum theory. So Planck's quantum theory was established in 1900 and it was given by Max Planck just to explain the phenomenon of black body radiation and photoelectric effect. So what are the main postulates of Planck's quantum theory? So the main postulates means statements. So the main postulates of Planck's quantum theory are, so there are three main postulates of Planck's quantum theory. The first postulate, the electromagnetic radiations are not emitted or absorbed continuously. Discontinuously in the form of small discrete packets of energies. Each such packet of energy is called a quantum. In case of light, the quantum of energy is called a photon. So see, in the black body radiation, we know that black body is an ideal system which absorbs all the frequencies of radiation which follow it. And when it absorbs all the frequencies of radiation which follow it, and when the black body is heated, it again emits all the frequencies of radiation, absorbed. Now, Planck's quantum theory said that the electromagnetic radiations are not emitted or absorbed continuously. So these are electromagnetic radiations. So these are not emitted or absorbed continuously. So continuously emission bhi nahi hota hai, continuously absorption bhi nahi hota hai. But discontinuously in the form of small discrete packet of energies. So these radiations are emitted discontinuously. So some amount of emitted. Again, some amount of emitted. Similarly, some amount of energy absorbed, some amount of radiation absorbed, some amount of radiation absorbed. So these are discontinuous. So emission of the electromagnetic radiations and absorption of the electromagnetic radiations takes place discontinuously, not continuously. So each such packet of energy, so this much radiation, this much radiation, this much radiation, these are the packets of energy, and each such packet of energy is called a quantum. This is quantum of energy. But in case of light, this quantum of energy is called a photon. These are photon in case of light, but in case of other particles, these are called quantum of energy. So this is the first statement of Planck's quantum theory. Electromagnetic radiations are not emitted or absorbed continuously, but discontinuously in the form of small discrete packet of energies. Small discrete packet of energies. So each such packet of energy is called a quantum. But in case of light, this quantum of energy is called a photon. So this is the first statement. Second statement, the energy of each quantum is directly proportional to the frequency of radiation. So the energy of each quantum is directly proportional to the frequency of radiation. So we can write that is the energy of each quantum is directly proportional to the frequency of radiation. So E is directly proportional to nu, or we can write E equals to one constant, H nu. Here H is Planck's constant, and this H is inputted in photoelectric effect. H nu minus H nu naught. There H is the Planck's constant. The Planck's constant came from Planck's quantum theory. So E equals to H nu, where H is Planck's constant. So where H is Planck's constant. And we know every constant has a definite value. So Planck's constant ka value kitna hai? Its value is 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 27 arc second. 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 27 arc second. So arc second mein hone se this quantity is used in CGS unit, or 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second. So this quantity is expressed in SI unit, so international standard unit. 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second. So the value of Planck's constant is 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second. So this is the second statement. The energy of each quantum each quantum is directly proportional to the frequency of radiation. Third statement, the total amount of energy the total amount यहाँ पे देखो, these are the single quantum, this is single quantum, single quantum, single quantum. तो एक single quantum का energy directly proportional to the frequency of radiation. So one black body can absorb a number of large number of radiations, and it can also emits a large number of radiations, although discontinuously. So the total amount of energy emitted or absorbed by a body, so total amount of energy emitted, these are the total amount of energy, total amount of energy emitted or absorbed by a body will be some whole number quanta. The total amount of energy emitted or absorbed by a body will be some whole number quanta. So quantum is the singular form, quantum. So quantum is one, only one, one packet of energy. And quanta, it is the plural form, a large number of quantum of energy. So that is, we can write, that is E equals to n h nu. So for one quantum of energy, E equals to h nu, and total amount of energy, that is E equals to n h nu, where n is any integer. N is any integer. So here you see how many quantum of energy emitted or absorbed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So here E equals to 6 h nu. So bas complete ho gaya Planck's quantum theory. So what is Planck's quantum theory? So in order to explain the phenomenon of black body radiation and photoelectric effect, Max Planck in 1900 put forward a theory known as Planck's quantum theory. The main postulates of this theory are, number one, the electromagnetic radiations are not emitted or absorbed continuously, but discontinuously in the form of small discrete packets of energies. Each such packet of energy is called a quantum. In case of light, the quantum of energy is called a photon. Number two, the energy of each quantum is directly proportional to the frequency of radiation. That is, E is directly proportional to nu, or E equals to h nu, where h is Planck's constant and its value is 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 27 arc second, or 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second. So minus 34 joule second, this value is in SI unit. Third statement, the total amount of energy emitted or absorbed by a body will be some whole number quanta, that is E equals to n h nu, where n is any integer. So these are the three statements of Planck's quantum theory. Now one question, what is photon? The photon is a particle of इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक, फोटोन इज अ पार्टिकल ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशन, द अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी इन फोटोन इज गिवन बाय आइंस्टाइन इक्वेशन, एंड द फेमस आइंस्टाइन इक्वेशन इज ई इक्वल्स टू एम सी स्क्वायर, तो ई इक्वल्स टू एम सी स्क्वायर, दैट इज आइंस्टाइन इक्वेशन। तो यहां पे एम क्या है, तो एम इज द मास ऑफ फोटोन, मास ऑफ फोटोन, व्हाट इज सी हैविंग, सी इज वेलोसिटी, हैविंग वेलोसिटी सी, तो ई इक्वल्स टू एम सी स्क्वायर, दैट इज आइंस्टाइन इक्वेशन। बाय दिस इक्वेशन आइंस्टाइन एक्सप्रेसेस द एनर्जी ऑफ फोटोन, क्लियर। तो व्हाट इज फोटोन, फोटोन इज अ पार्टिकल, दिस आर फोटॉन्स इन केस ऑफ लाइट, तो इन केस ऑफ लाइट दिस क्वांटम ऑफ एनर्जी इज कॉल्ड फोटोन, बट व्हाट इज फोटोन, तो फोटोन इज अ पार्टिकल ऑफ, इज अ पार्टिकल ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशन, एंड द अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी इन फोटोन इज गिवन बाय आइंस्टाइनस इक्वेशन, एंड आइंस्टाइनस इक्वेशन इज इक्वल्स टू एम सी स्क्वायर। द एनर्जी ऑफ क्वांटम अकॉर्डिंग टू प्लैंक्स क्वांटम थ्योरी इज इक्वल्स टू एच न्यू, तो ई इक्वल्स टू एच न्यू, दैट इज अकॉर्डिंग टू प्लैंक द एनर्जी ऑफ क्वांटम, एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू आइंस्टाइन द एनर्जी ऑफ ए फोटोन इज गिवन बाय ई इक्वल्स टू एम सी स्क्वायर। सो द एनर्जी ऑफ फोटोन and the energy of quantum represents the same species. So since photon and quantum represents the same species, for example s particle in photon, because photon is a particle of electromagnetic radiation, so for particle the energy of photon is mc square, e equals to mc square, and for energy, according to Planck's quantum theory, the energy of each quantum is E equals to h nu. So therefore, we can write m c square is equals to h nu, or m c square is equals to h into what is nu? We have the relation c equals to lambda into nu. Or nu is equals to c by lambda, so nu is equals to, you can write c by lambda. So here 1c is cancelled, so mc is equals to h by lambda. So now one question. Question: Calculate the frequency and energy of a photon. Photon of radiation having wavelength of 6000 angstrom. To calculate the frequency and energy of a photon of radiation having wavelength of 6000 angstrom. तो अभी कैलकुलेट करना है एक फोटोन का फ्रीक्वेंसी एंड इट्स एनर्जी व्हेन इट हैव वेवलेंथ 6000 एंगस्ट्रॉम। तो सॉल्यूशन, तो हियर Oyablan. Wavelength is lambda, and lambda is equals to 6000 armstrong, and 6000 armstrong is written as 6000 into 10 to the power minus 10 meter. So we have frequency. Frequency is nu, and nu is equals to c by lambda. So what is c? C is velocity of light, and velocity of light is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. The value of lambda is 6000 into 10 to the power minus 10 meter. So here meter cancel. So 3 by 6 into 10 to the power 8, or it has a 3 0 cancel. So we get 10 to the power minus 7. Minus 7 upper and plus 7. So 8 plus 7. 15, 2, that is half. Half means 0.5 into 10 to the power 15. Unit is second inverse, or you can write 5. So you say 10 like multiply here. 5 into 10 to the power 14 second inverse. So this is your answer. If you write up to this much, then also you will get full marks. But standard form of writing is like this. After one digit, there should be decimal point. So 5.0 you can write, or only 5 into 10 to the power 14 second inverse. So this is the frequency. Now you have to calculate energy. So now energy. So energy, that is E, and we have E equals to H nu. This is also equals to, now see, nu is frequency, but here frequency value is 5 into 10 to the power 14 second inverse, and H is Planck's constant, and we know the value of Planck's constant. What is the value of Planck's constant? 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second. This is Planck's constant into the value of nu. Nu is frequency, and frequency value is 5 into 10 to the power 14 second inverse. We have a second inverse cancel. The 5 6 to multiply, 5 6 are 33, 5 2 are 10 plus 3 13 1, 5 6 are 30 plus 1 31 3, 5, 6 are 30 plus 3, 33. The decimal is after 3 digit, 1, 2, 3. So 33.13 into 10 to the power minus 34 and plus 14. So radian minus 20. Unit remains only joule. The standard form of writing is after 1 digit decimal. So we can write 3.313. 3 point likha se kya hua? 10 se divide hua. We have a 10 se multiply hua. 10 se multiply hone se 10 to the power minus 19 joule. So this is the answer. So frequency and energy of photon is, frequency is 5 into 10 to the power 14 second inverse, and energy is 3.313 into 10 to the power minus 19 joule. Another question. So another question is, the threshold frequency, that is mu naught, for a metal is 7 into 10 to the power 14 second inverse. So a metal ka threshold frequency is 7 into 10 to the power 14 second inverse. That means a metal se electron ko eject karne ke liye minimum frequency is required 7 into 10 to the power 14 second inverse. Calculate the काइनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफ एन इलेक्ट्रॉन एमिटेड, तो जो भी इलेक्ट्रॉन एमिट हुआ उसका काइनेटिक एनर्जी कैलकुलेट करना है. व्हेन रेडिएशन ऑफ फ्रीक्वेंसी, दैट मींस इंसिडेंट फ्रीक्वेंसी, न्यू इज इक्वल्स टू 1 इनटू 10 टू द पावर 15 सेकंड इनवर्स हिट दिस मेटल. तो जब मेटल को इंसिडेंट फ्रीक्वेंसी हिट किया विद 1 इनटू 10 टू द पावर 15 सेकंड इनवर्स से, देन दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन इज इजेक्टेड. यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट द काइनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफ दिस इजेक्टेड इलेक्ट्रॉन. तो दिस इज इंसिडेंट फ्रीक्वेंसी एंड इट्स थ्रेशोल्ड फ्रीक्वेंसी इज रिक्वायर्ड 7 इंटू 10 टू द पावर 14 सेकेंड इनवर्स. दिस इंफॉर्मेशन आर गिवन, यू नीड टू फाइंड आउट काइनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफ द इजेक्टेड इलेक्ट्रॉन. सोल्यूशन, तो वी हैव काइनेटिक एनर्जी of ejected electron, kinetic energy of ejected electron. So kinetic energy of ejected electron, that is half mv square, is equals to h nu minus h nu naught. So we have this formula, half mv square is equals to h nu minus h nu naught. So h common, तो न्यू माइनस न्यू नॉट, एच कॉमन, तो न्यू न्यू इज द इंसिडेंट फ्रीक्वेंसी एंड इंसिडेंट फ्रीक्वेंसी इज गिवन 1.0 इनटू 10 टू द पावर 15 सेकेंड इनवर्स माइनस थ्रेशोल्ड फ्रीक्वेंसी इज गिवन 7.0 इनटू 10 टू द पावर 14 सेकेंड इनवर्स. तो एच इनटू यहाँ पे 10 टू द पावर 15 यहाँ पे 14 दोनों मेरे को सेम करते थे तो यहाँ से 10 से मल्टीप्लाई हो तो 1 इंटू 10 मीन्स 10 तो 10.0 इंटू 10 टू द पावर 14 सेकेंड इनवर्स यहाँ से 10 से मल्टीप्लाई हो गया तो 1 इंटू 10 मीन्स 10 इंटू 10 टू द पावर 14 रहेगा सेकेंड इनवर्स माइनस 7.0 इंटू 10 टू द पावर 14 सेकेंड इनवर्स. So h into to 10 to the power 14, 10 to the power 14 common. So here we have 10 minus 7. 10 minus 7 is 3. So 3.0 into 10 to the power 14 unit second inverse. Now put down the value of h. So h is Planck's constant. Planck's constant ka value hai 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second into this value. So 3.0 into 10 to the power 14 second inverse. So second inverse cancel. So 3 se isko multiply karne se 3 6 are 18, 1 3 2 are 6 plus 1 7, 3 6 are 18, 1 3 6 are 18 plus 1 19 after 3 digit decimal 1 2 3 19.878 into 10 to the power minus 34 plus 14, that means minus 20 unit radian joule after 1 digit 1.9878 into 10 to the power yes kya hua 10 se divide hua to 10 multiply karne se minus 19 joule. So this is your answer 1.9878 into 10 to the power minus 19 joule. Kinetic energy, that is half mv square. So kinetic energy of the ejected electron is this. Another question. So here you see, the next question is, when electromagnetic radiation of wavelength 300 nanometer falls off the surface of sodium. So this is surface of sodium and wavelength ready. The wavelength is 300 nanometer. So 300 nanometer falls on the surface of sodium. Electrons are emitted. Electron emit ho gaya. With kinetic energy. So kinetic energy of this electron is 1.68 into 10 to the power 5 joule or more. You need to find out what is the minimum energy needed to remove an electron from sodium. So minimum amount of energy kitna chahiye, that is threshold frequency kitna chahiye to remove that electron from this surface of the sodium. Energy needed to remove an electron. See here, an electron, one electron ko remove karne ke liye kitna energy chahiye. Answer. So here wavelength lambda is given 300 nanometer. So that is equals to 300 into 10 to the power minus 9 meter. So energy. So therefore, energy of electron. So energy of electron E equals to, we have H nu, nu is frequency, but frequency value is not given, wavelength is given. So we can convert nu to C by lambda. So this is equals to, the value of H is 6.626. into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second into, to C is velocity of light and its value is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, and lambda value is given 300 into 10 to the power minus 9 meter. So here second, second inverse cancel, meter, meter cancel. 100 for 10 to the power minus 9, that means you have an area 10 to the power minus 7. So 6.626 into 10 to the power, here pe hai minus 34, here pe hai plus 8, or here 20 minus 9 on a minus 7, minus 7 upon a plus 7. So 8 plus 7, 15. Unit rege only joule. 6.626 into 10 to the power 34 से 15 चला जाने से 19. तो 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 19 joule is the energy of electron. तो now energy of one mole of electron, तो one mole of electron में कितना आता है? तो one mole of sodium atom कौन दे? 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 electrons. So we can multiply this value. तो 6.626. This is energy of one electron, 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 19 joule, that is energy of one electron. And energy of one mole of electron is 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 per mole. So it is multiplied by Avogadro's number, because one mole of electron contains Avogadro's number of electrons. So ye dono multiply karne se answer 6.626 and 6.022, 12, 5, 12, 13, 2, 5, 2, 3, 1, उसके बाद 0, 0, 0, 0, 6, 6 सर 36, 6 to 12 plus 3, 15, 6 is 36 plus 1, 37, 3, 6, 6 is 36 plus 3, 39. 2, 7, 7, 11, 10, 9, 9, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 39.9. So 39.9 into 10 to the power 19 and 23, 4 joule per mole. So we can write 3.99 into 10 to the power, 10 से divide हुआ, 10 multiply होगा, joule per mole. So energy of one mole of electron is this below, but energy of one electron is this below. Now we have to calculate minimum energy needed to remove one electron, and we have the kinetic energy. So S kinetic energy is equals to E naught plus half mv square. From photoelectric effect we have this formula. So therefore minimum energy required to remove an electron from sodium from, so this will be equals to E minus kinetic energy. Here you can write from sodium is equals to E minus kinetic energy. So this value equals to E is the energy. Energy of, so E is the total energy, and total energy is 3.99 into 10 to the power 5 joule per mole. Per mole, that means for one mole. And kinetic energy is, the minimum energy is threshold energy, and threshold energy is E naught. So E naught is equals to E minus kinetic energy. So kinetic energy value is given 1.68 into 10 to the power 5 joule per mole. So why we calculate energy of electron for one mole? Because kinetic energy value is given for one mole, joule per mole, for one mole. That's why we calculate the energy of electron per mole. So 3.99 minus 1.68. 9 से 8 जन से 1, 9 से 6 3, 3 से 1 2, 2.31 into 10 to the power 5 is common, joule per mole. तो minimum energy required to remove an electron from sodium requires this energy. अभी हमें चाहिए for an electron, one electron को remove करने के लिए कितना energy चाहिए? So we can write here thus minimum energy required to remove an electron or one electron from sodium is equals to 2.31 into 10 to the power 5 joule per mole divided by Avogadro's number 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 per mole, 3.83 into 10 minus 19. तो फर्स्ट आंसर हो गया, हाउ मच एनर्जी इज रिक्वायर्ड टू रिमूव एन इलेक्ट्रॉन, वन इलेक्ट्रॉन. फॉर मिनिमम एनर्जी रिक्वायर्ड टू रिमूव वन इलेक्ट्रॉन इज दिस वैल्यू. सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द आंसर. अभी कैलकुलेट करना है व्हाट इज द मैक्सिमम वेवलेंथ दैट विल कॉज अ फोटो इलेक्ट्रॉन टू बी एमिटेड. तो फोटो इलेक्ट्रॉन को एमिट करने के लिए
अभी मैक्सिमम वेवलेंथ कितना चाहिए?
सो द वेवलेंथ कॉरस्पॉन्डिंग टू दिस एनर्जी इज कैलकुलेटेड एस ई इक्वल्स टू एच न्यू, दैट इज इक्वल्स टू एच इनटू सी बाय लैम्डा. तो लैम्डा इज द वेवलेंथ. सो लैम्डा इज इक्वल्स टू लैम्डा यहां पे आ गया, ई यहां पे आ गया, तो एच इनटू सी बाय ई. सो द वैल्यू ऑफ एच इज 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second into C. So C is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second divided by E. E is the energy and energy value is 3.83. Energy 3.83 into 10 to the power minus 19 joule. On calculation, we get 5.17 into 10 to the power minus 7 meter. So this is the wavelength. You have to calculate these values. How this value came? You have to calculate. This value will be multiplied by 3 and then divided by 3.83. This comes out to be 5.17. 10 to the power minus 7 units. Bus complete. So this is end of today's class. Thank you.